Hello, it's Jang here with a look at a Lego architecture set that comes with 695 pieces. I am American, born and raised here, and I don't speak any French whatsoever, so I'm just going to use the pronunciation Louvre, and that's the end of that. To understand exactly what you're looking at here, though, I find it important to check the booklet, the instruction booklet, and one of the nice photographs they include is this one. This really shows the angle at which this model is captured. It's from this angle looking towards the right. So normally when you think of this place, which is a large complex, a lot of photographs are taken from this direction here. There's the whole long central courtyard, you know, this large open park space, and folks walk in this way and take pictures from all around in here. So this is an example of that, facing in towards the main oldest part of the building, and then there are these two wings that come out in a inverted U shape. However, this right here is not looking in this direction. It's looking out in this direction towards the wing that is to the right, which is how you see it like this. So the previous photo was taken from back here looking this way. This is towards the courtyard here. So that's why there is this open space right here. This is the walkway. This is the entranceway. So you're seeing the right side, small pyramid back here, a piece, just one section of the right wing of the complex, and then most of the stuff that you normally see would be out here, and it's just not there. So that to me is a very strange kind of starting point for the thing. I would have expected to see the center, the oldest building, to be kind of the focus of this thing, but they went to the side. So let's just kind of take it from that context. First of all, the large pyramid in the center does use just about as many clear pieces as it could, so it looks nice and crisp and glass and kind of crystalline. That's a good thing. Does have to use a couple of non-clear pieces down at the base. These are all just hinged assemblies, and I think if you look there carefully, you can see how this is stacked up. You've got 1x2 plates and then 1x1 plates and cheese slopes on the side, and you can see that that's just hinged. They just put a couple of bars, well, one bar on each side, and they're able to clip these on. A little bit of support structure in the center just to get the top of it that fits on up there. The small little pyramid off to the side, which is on the back of this model, is even simpler still, and it looks fine. And then they represent some of the water areas, some of the little pools, man-made pool bits with just tiles on top of plates. And I think they look fine. At first glance, I was a little bit confused trying to figure out what part there was trying to be glass, but I get it now. It makes sense. As for the main structure itself, there, you know, usually architecture sets have a lot of really interesting building techniques. This one did not. This one was a very straightforward build, to be honest with you. The main pyramid out towards the front is the trickiest thing, and that's not very tricky at all. This was just straightforward, and that's fine. The most important thing is just capturing authentically the important features of the structure that they're trying to make. And I think they have good parts choice with the kind of arched window pieces. Some of them are facing with the outsides towards us here, and then these up here are facing with the outsides back, just to inset them a little bit. I think it works out just fine. Yeah, it would have been nice to get a little more rounding up here, but I don't know how they could have done it. This is also very hollow. You notice on the back, three of these large 1x6x5 panel pieces, and all of the inside is completely hollow, because might as well be. They do have some window bits kind of represented on the back with the clear bricks, which I think just allow a little bit of extra light to come through towards the front. Not too much. Doesn't really, you know, unless you really get down there and have a good bright light coming behind it, really doesn't light up the inside that much. But I think it all works out just fine. It just wasn't that impressive of a process to put it together. My favorite thing here, as far as what they did to get the textures in there, is the use of these these rounded textured bricks that have the two lumps on either side to just get a little bit of extra inset in there to create some of the vertical lines. Now, I do believe this is one of the larger scaled Lego architecture sets, not larger sized, but larger scaled. Its actual scale relative to its real size. So that struck me as a little bit interesting. I think they could have made this smaller, but I'm glad that they didn't. I do like having the larger thing, and especially the larger courtyard section and the larger pyramid there that makes for a nice display. You know, the thing looks good. It's just it's the picture. The 3D picture that we're looking at here is taken from an awkward angle, and I wish so strongly that they had taken the picture from the angle that shows the main building and puts the main building right in the center, so it would have gotten some nice symmetry as well. Of course, as with all the architecture sets, the price is pretty high for what you get, for the volume of what you get when the thing is completely assembled like this. The price per part is actually very good on this one. It's superior to 10 cents per part. It's less than 10 cents per part on this in the US at least. So objectively, relatively speaking, it's doing pretty well, but a lot of those parts are small. And even though there is a lot of hollow space inside of the building, it still feels like you pay a lot for what you end up getting. So in the end, I personally am not super impressed by this thing. The real thing looks really nice. The pyramid is a shiny thing, and shiny things tend to impress the human eye. But I really feel like this set isn't reverent enough to the source material. I really feel like it should have faced the oldest part of the building. It should have faced the center. Would have been nice to get it in a smaller scale, actually. And to get the actual U-shape, you know, to get a representation of the center, and then some of both wings to the left and the right. So, and obviously value is always a big question mark with the architecture sets. There's no difference with this one in that sense. But overall, I just feel like this doesn't capture the essence of reality well enough. And like I said, it just doesn't give enough respect to the actual Louvre. Please leave a comment on the video with your thoughts, what you think about this as a Lego set, and what you think about it as a model of the Louvre itself. Thank you in advance for your feedback. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.